Okay, to Sonia in San Jose, listening on Immaculate Heart Radio. Hi, Sonia, how are you?
Hello, how are you?
Very well, Sonia. Thanks for your call.
So my question is, my 8-year-old today came home from school and said his friend, who's a 10-year-old, said that God doesn't exist.
Okay.
And he says, well, there's no evidence that God exists. And I said, no, there is evidence that God exists. And my son said, well, can you give me something so I can show it to him?
Well, it's a challenging question because there is certainly evidence that God exists, but in order to be able to appreciate it when you're dealing with someone coming from a skeptical perspective, it can get into some fairly deep waters philosophically. And how much an 8-year-old would be able to successfully communicate to a 10-year-old of, say, Aquinas' Five Ways is something that is a little iffy. There are ways of talking to children about the existence of God, but they're usually not up to handling a philosophical proof of God's existence. Now, there are things that you can do. Like, I mean, when I was 5 years old, I don't know that I've ever told this story publicly before, but when I was 5 years old, I became aware that the father of a couple of friends of mine was an atheist. And I said, you know, I had not encountered that concept before, that someone didn't believe in God's existence. And so I said, well, okay, God made everything, therefore God made the planets. The planets clearly exist, therefore God must exist. And so this was my reasoning as a 5-year-old. I had invented a primitive form of the cosmological argument. And so I went to my friends and said, well, if your dad doesn't believe in the existence of God, who does he think made the planets? And they said, he doesn't know. And so, you know, on the kind of 5-year-old level, I sort of won that one. But it's a challenge to, you know, today, if I were to articulate the cosmological argument, which doesn't actually have to involve planets, it just involves the universe as a whole, I would do it in a much more sophisticated way. The trick and the challenge would be finding something that an 8-year-old could say to a 10-year-old in this case. And rather than try to do that, I mean, you could use the kind of argument that I just did about the planets, but that may not convince a skeptical 10-year-old. Of course, no argument will convince a committed skeptic, and so there may be a limit to what you can do to begin with. But one thing that you might consider doing is kind of taking the question up a level. And because what an 8-year-old could say is, you know, you and I are very young and we're still growing, we're still learning, we're not the experts, but there are very famous, very smart people who have considered this question, and the great majority of them have concluded that God exists. And so, you know, we may need to wait until we grow up to fully appreciate their arguments. And I know your parents may say something different about this than my parents, but the truth is that the great majority of people who have looked at this question have concluded that God exists, and they're older and have studied more and know more than we do. One day we'll know just as much as them, but we're not there yet, and so we should go along with the best evidence that we have based on what the experts say, just like we go along with the best evidence we have, say, based on what medical experts like doctors say. So I would consider having him discuss the question in those terms, not in terms of what he as an 8-year-old can prove, but what the experts who have considered the question as adults have concluded.
How does that sound, Sonia?
Okay, I will talk to my son about that. And because I raised my kids to fully believe that God exists.
Good.
And everything else, so in their minds, they know and they believe completely that God do exist.
Good. And at one thing, and I'll mention it, I have a book out right now called A Daily Defense, where I go through in a very simple way different arguments for the existence of God. And if you check that out, you might be able to pick up some ideas from that that your children might be able to understand at the different ages they are.
Thank you, Sonia, for your phone call to Catholic Answers Live.